Alright, let's go.
Have you ever seen a kid's legs up close? They look really nice, like buttered toast. And if you ever said Edward in his face, he'd slap your mama and say you're a disgrace. He's disrespectful, doesn't go to church. Just kidding, he always does his homework. He goes to college, and he's got a lot of knowledge. Ask him about Jesus Christ, and he's got your answers.
All about how my life got flipped, turned upside down. And I'd like to take a minute just sitting right there. I'll tell you how I became the prince of a town called Bel Air. In West Philadelphia, born and raised on the playground of Hamilton, both of my days. Chilling out, maxing, relaxing, on cool and on shooting some ball outside of school. When a couple of guys who were up to no good started making trouble in my neighborhood. I got in one little fight and my mom got scared and said, "You're moving with your auntie and uncle in Bel-Air." I begged and pleaded with her day after day, but she packed my suitcase and sent me on my way. She gave me a kiss and then she gave me my ticket. I put my Walkman on and said, "I might as well kick it. First class, yo, this is bad. Drinking orange juice out of a champagne glass. Is this what the people of Bel-Air living like? This might be alright. But wait, I hear the frisky food's lying all wet. Is this the type of place they send this cool cat? I don't think so. I'll see when I get there. I hope you're prepared for the Prince of Bel-Air." I pulled up to the house about 7 or 8, and I yelled to the cabbie, "Yo, home, smell you later." Looked at my kingdom, I was finally there to sit on my throne as the Prince of Bel-Air.